Now, under Unit 3, what we are going to learn is about the development, scientific developments. And about the scientific developments, why we should learn? That is because we should be careful. If at all there is a scientific gadget, how careful should we be? That we have to question ourselves, right? If at all we simply put the button on, switch on, we are getting these lights, these fans, this AC, everything is run by the electricity. Did we question any time to ourselves? Have we questioned any time to ourselves? What is that one? From where do we get this electricity, the power? How costly it is? Did we ask any time? No, never. And all the times we are being told, what is done? Save energy, conserve power, conserve water. But we don't hear about it. We don't bother for it. And I want my part. I want my part. Everybody is using. Why I should not? So for why I should not, it itself shows that you are careless. If at all we are careless for that energy, power, then one day you should become powerless. Because you have utilized your own complete power, you are consumed. So you have to retain your power, whether it is your basilar power or mechanical power or electrical power or solar power, whatsoever, hydrostatic power, pneumatic power, whatever the power is, you have to conserve it. Means what? I shall not use it. No, use it. Then up to the limits, whatever you want, that much only you have to use it. Remaining, keep it off. Right? So that is carelessness. If at all you are careless, then you are becoming careless. Why? The second one is fuel, where we are to be very cautious in using it. Fuel, the rate at which we are utilizing it, consuming it, in a few decades, we may become fuel-less. How many cars do you see around? Around 5 years ago when you are in class 5. And when you are in class 10 now, how many cars do you see? Put the cars aside. How many bikes do you see? How many variants of bikes do you see? Right? And again, at the every junction where the red light is glowing, you have been asked to stop. You stop there. You are stationed, you have stationed yourself. But you go on accelerating here. Brum, 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 brum. Why can't you stop that? Why don't you stop that? Right? So that is the way we are wasting it. We are not utilizing, we are not consuming. Alongside, we are wasting it also. Consume that much which is necessary for you. Even if it comes to water and food even, what are we doing? Whatever we prepared last night, that becomes stale now, and we are simply throwing it. By simply throwing, and again, in the vegetable market, if you go to the market there, how much is being thrown there? Just see. Even if it is flower market, vegetable market, or your what we call fruit market, people prefer to throw it than to consume it. This throw away rubbish, it emits, it pollutes the air. Then ultimately you will be having breathing problems. And it was 1 to 1000 for asthmatic cases. Asthma, it was 1 to 1000. Now it is 1000 to 1000. Everybody has that asthma feeling within you. Breathing problem. Suffocation we feel. The part in your body which needs this air is not only this nose. Then your skin, every pore needs that air. If that air is not there, if it is not a pure one, then you are getting suffocated. So what makes this pollution? The careless usage of the car. Careless usage of this car, motors, consumption of fuel, consumption of your electricity. So consumption of electricity, how it pollutes. You see to it, keep the lights on here in this room. For 5 minutes, you go away from the room. For 5 minutes, you leave these lights on and enter again and see how humid and how hot this area becomes. The heated air is a polluted air. So keep off everything when they are not being utilized. And even using the bike. I am going to school. Next door to me is one more teacher going to the same school. Do we share the vehicle? No. Because he goes early and I go later. How much early and how much later? By 2 minutes. I can't adjust these 2 minutes and I can't ride my bicycle with him. I don't want to share. And he doesn't want to share his own vehicle. Two people or three people coming from the same locality to the same working place, they don't use a common vehicle. Because a vehicle, it is said to be a status symbol. I have the BMW. Why I should go in his Maruti 800? Why I should? No. My status will be lowered. They bother for the status and they are careless for the usage of the car. And one day, what it results is, we may become carless. We may have to ride a bicycle to my working place. This is a thought put over here, given to us. Let us think. Let us make a survey. How many students, how many parents, how many office goers are utilizing their own individual vehicle? Is it Wagoner? Is it Maruti 800? Alto 800? Or it is BMW? Is it petrol vehicle? Or it is CNG vehicle? Or it is a diesel vehicle? You see how much of the carbon monoxide is being emitted into the atmospheric air. God has given this atmosphere to enjoy. And we are polluting this atmosphere which God has given and we are enjoying. See to it. So this survey helps us to understand how deliberately human being is polluting his own environment. And where he is leading himself to, he is leading himself to a zero. That is what is the opening of this unit 3. So here we see there are certain points. The harmful gases emitted into the atmosphere from the vehicles are polluting the environment, especially the air we breathe. Breathing, it is not only restricted to this, mind you. Sometimes your eyes are having burning sensation. Why? It is not getting enough fresh air. It needs it. And our, what is it called, your shin and your feet, they also having the burning sensation. Why? Because continuously you are standing on your two-wheeler, and your shin is just opposite to the silencer of the next body's vehicle, and it, suppose it happens to be a truck, that will be here and he will be emitting that carbon monoxide black smoke, and that sits on our body and everywhere it burns, it itches, because every part of your skin needs fresh air that we are not giving. So that we have to understand. So be an eco journalist and do your bit to help reduce air pollution. And the first step towards saving the environment is to know where we stand and ask your dad, "Dad, let us share uncle's vehicle." "No, no, uncle will think I am miserly. He may think I may not spend on my vehicle." Don't do that. Weekly 3 days use his vehicle. Weekly 3 days use our vehicle. Right? Or while buying itself, let us both put the money in and buy one vehicle. He may use and I may also use. "No, yaar, he doesn't know how to maintain the vehicle." If he doesn't know, you maintain the vehicle then on a regular basis. That amicability, that friendship we don't have when it comes to the a vehicle which stands as the symbol of my status symbol. When it comes to, I don't bother for it. Now, carrying out the outdoor or door-to-door survey, and many points have been given, a tabulation has been given. If we maintain and see, then we can understand each and every house, how many vehicles they have. How many vehicles they have. If it is a joint family, all the elderly male persons should have a car to go to his working place. Because I am a businessman and I am doing my business in crores, if I go in a Maruti van or in a Maruti 800, Alto 800, no, people don't care. And so I should go in a SUV, right? Made or foreign vehicle, I should. So that ego point should be reduced to the level where we are not polluting the air. To that level, we have to reduce our ego. Why status symbol? Because of the ego only, I want to show myself. So that is what is taught here in A. Right? Now, A2, what we have? We have an article about solar power. Solar power, when we say, it is a non-conventional energy. What is conventional energy? The energy which we know. Hydel power we know. Right? So solar energy, it is also non-conventional energy. Right? So, and moreover, what is this solar energy? Let us just think about it. And as long as the sun is there, that energy cannot be stopped. So the energy what we are generating out of the solar heat of the sun rays, that is renewable power. What a hydel power is there, right? We are putting very big generators over there and turbines over there. The water is falling on that and turbine is, we are rotating it, and through that we are getting the energy, the power, electricity. Okay, hydel electricity. And the water is not there. Then whatever it generated in the past few months, it will be consumed within very less months now. Then the power zero. Right? Battery is there. In cell we are using, in trucks we are using, in cars we are using. Everywhere we are having the usage of the battery. And unless that is recharged, some of the batteries are rechargeable batteries. Again, we have to recharge. For half an hour or 1 hour, you recharge it, and there we can use it for 6 hours or 10 hours or 12 hours. That way, we are using rechargeable batteries. Right? And the recharging through solar panels, how much you are spending on that? Is it one time spending or a regular spending? That way, the things we have to think very closely, then we can understand, we can know about it, we can invent new things, or we may discover those things which have not been discovered earlier, and we may put it into our use. Right? So, what we are going to read about is solar power. With energy consumption being the buzzword, now the buzzword. What are the buzzword means what? It is, we are going into a dangerous zone. That is buzzword. Very busily people are talking about that. Means we are using every unit of our power generated. Now we may go without power for some days in summer. Power cuts will be there. We may not be giving enough power to the farmers. We may not be giving enough power to the what we call as industries. So industrial growth should be there. Agriculture growth should be there. Then only we can grow. And so we may compromise with no power for certain hours because we are not having enough water in our hydroelectrical power stations. Then thermal or nuclear. We may go for thermal means what? Emittance of dust, emittance of smoke. Again, we are polluting the air. And nuclear. Nuclear, of course, it is pollution wise, it is safer. But the disaster it makes, even if some water enters into. Why? So very recently, Japan, two nuclear power stations were in danger. The seawater was going inside. What they have done, only God knows, but they have prevented. If not, they would have faced one more Hiroshima and Nagasaki once again. So whatever way we are going, we are generating, no doubt, the power we are generating, but everything may face a catastrophe somewhere, a stoppage somewhere. So the solar energy, so far it has not been tapped. It is a very big source. As long as the sun rises in the sky, we can utilize it. And it is a non-stopping one. Right? And now the focus is on that solar power. With energy consumption being a buzzword in developing economic around the world, fears of an energy crisis looming ahead are not totally unfounded. People have found it. Yes, energy crisis is looming. Looming means spreading. It is covering. The energy may not be there. One day we may be a failure. How long the Kuwait petrol or crude oil wells can work up? How long? For how many days? There can be a zero level somewhere. Because groundwater levels have come to zero level during the last season. And Hyderabadis, they were very much worried. If this rainy season, if we don't have rains, we may have to vacate Hyderabad. That was the situation. And many parts of Hyderabad, they were not having potable water. Then because now the rains are good and underground water levels have increased. This may happen with the water, but with the petroleum, crude oil, how? Do you mean to say the crude oil will be raining and it may seep into the ground and again the wells can produce crude oil? No. There is a fixed amount of crude oil there. And if that has been pumped out, then Very shortly, we may run out of the fuel. We are consuming it, but we may run short of that fuel. People have known it already. They found it. And so they are in the run to make other alternative sources for the energy and power, fuel, three things. So the non-renewable nature of fossil, non-renewable means it is not raining crude oil. Whatever we are excavating, whatever we are pumping out, that is gone and it may go for zero level. That is called non-renewable. Your bore wells, etc., they are renewable. Because if the rains are there, water seep inside, water may come up. Renewable. But here, oil is not getting rained. So that is a non-renewable nature of fossil. What is this fossil? Let me give you a small understanding about fossil. All the living things, after a great destruction, they are covered with heavy loads of stones and this rubble we are pressed under. And great pressure occurs. Under the great pressure and temperature, our body, the living creatures or living things, they get compressed completely. And whatever the liquid form is there in our body, that escapes and that gets thickened. It becomes very thick. Not in 1 or 2 years, for the centuries, if it is under that pressure and a liquid is taken out, comes out, it is not taken out, comes out. And that liquid gets thickened and that turns into crude oil. And whatever is compressed, the solid is there, that becomes black, 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 and that turns into your coal. That is the process of formation of fossil fuel. Means what? Knowingly, you are to put many living bodies under the earth. We don't do it. Unless there is a great disaster like a very big earthquake or a very big, volcano eruption or a very big tsunami, right? Only then this may happen. If not, doesn't happen. So we are conquering tsunamis, we are conquering earthquakes, we are conquering the natural disasters. Then can it be a renewable fossil fuel? Is it a renewable one? No. If at all it has to become renewable, it becomes some thousands and thousands of years to get that again fossil fuel. So it is a non-renewable fuel. So now, after knowing that, fossil fuel makes complete dependence on these for future energy needs. A very decay a fire. Renewable energy sources are the best bet in the scenario, and what can be a better renewable resource than the sun? Now, as I described you, how to make it renewable, it is something which we cannot think. Which one? The fossil fuel. Then the need now is to depend on the renewable fuel. Then which can stand as an alternative for the fossil? It is nothing but solar energy. So we have to tap that area. In a country like India, if the abundant amount of sunlight available is harnessed, caught and put properly, it could mean an end to the energy crisis. It is the most abundant source of energy. The average global solar radiation is around 5 kilowatt hours, kWh, per square meter per day, with the sunshine hours ranging from 23 to 4300 per India. India is in the sunny belt or the world. The country receives solar energy equivalent to more than 5,000 trillion kWh per year, which is far more than its total annual energy consumption. So, if we harness solar power and that heat, and if we turn it into energy, that is equivalent to 5,000 trillion kWh in 1 year. And that is far, far, far more than your per year consumption we hold. Why? We are laying directly, right, under the what we call as the Capricorn and Cancer. That means we are in the tropical zone. Most of the sun heat falls here. And certain parts of Africa and certain parts of America, these are all falling under this solar zone, that is tropical zone, directly. And whatever the sun rays we get, that is enough to generate this much of electricity. Besides, it is a renewable and clean energy source. Not only that, it is sufficient, more than sufficient. Then what next is there? Besides that more than sufficiency, the solar energy, it is pollution free. Very clean energy it is. Unlike your, what we call as a thermal power or hydro power or your nuclear power, it is very keen, clean, and also no danger, right? Energy source, taking both environmental and economic cost. So now the water, whatever you are using for hydro power, to get that water we have to make dams, spending crores and crores of money over that, right? Let us not think hydrostatic electricity is a very hydroelectricity is a very cheaper electricity. No. And again, we are having the windmills, great windmills, pneumatic electrical power by the air. To erect that simple one mill, how much does it cost? With one, how much we are getting? With two, how much we are getting? With 100, how much we are getting? And what is the cost over there? Means economically viability also we have to see for that to generate electricity. Economically, if it is low, we need not to pay more for the electricity. Very low we can, or one time we can have our electrical solar panels overhead our house. We may generate enough for our night consumption. We may generate enough for our TV set to run. We may generate enough for our cell phones to run. See to it. And it is renewable. Now, today, the sun is not there. Tomorrow it will be there. The panels are open. And tomorrow we are collecting again electricity. We are using and we are collecting, storing. That way, it is economically viable, clean, and by the danger side also, it is not that dangerous. So, solar energy works cheaper than fossil fuel resources. If I am putting petrol into my vehicle, I am just thinking, is it, that means whether I am using it for the full 3 days, full 2 days? Likewise, because I have to go to workplace. I don't utilize it for the kilometer wise. Because kilometer wise, the companies say 60 kilometers per 1 liter. They may say 70, they may come up with 80. But there will be a condition over there. What is one? Subjected to road condition of your locality. Your road condition are very poor, then you have to raise your boom, boom, boom. Means what? You are using more power without output. Then your consumption levels are coming down. Our consumption is more and running is less. So here, so you are running from here to there with the electrical panel overhead. It may be cheaper. Charging a battery over there is maybe cheaper. So it can be vital, once we master techniques to harness solar energy, still we are finding out the cheaper means and ways to harness. Harness means to what? To collect it, gather it and collect it. Gather and collect is harness, H-A-R-N-E-S-S. Once if we have a viable and cheaper harnessing system with us, that is, the whenever the sun is there, the car can run. If it is cloudy, if car doesn't run, if it is rainy, we have to stick to one place, then again we are, it poses danger. And hence viability also we have to see, and the storing system also we have to develop. From the solar system we are storing here, and the battery is renewed and the battery is running the car. That way we are getting up the cheaper means to collect that harnessed energy. It can be a vital source of power on all planets. See, our sun is there, and around that there are many planets, right? And all these planets are getting solar power, the heat energy they are getting, every planet. So if at all we harness the system, we develop a system to turn the solar heat into your electricity, then it is useful wherever you go, into any planet you go. Solar energy could be a viable source of power generation for the next 1,000 crore years. Not 1,000 years, not 10 years, not 100 years. What we are bothering is, if I buy a vehicle, if I am comfortable on that, it's okay. That way you need not have to be a selfish. Why? The solar energy, through the heat what we are getting, through the radiation, it is enough to run any vehicle, anything, for thousand crore years, not 1,000 years alone, 1,000 crores. There are many technologies available for conversion of solar energy into solar power. Solar energy converted to solar power. There are many techniques, and there are many jigmos also we have. For instance, solar photovoltaic, SPV, solar power, solar photovoltaic, SPV technology, photo galvanic cells, solar steam generators, solar concentrating power, that is again solar tower or solar chimney, radio micrometers and thermopile are some of them. These are the some of the things where we are getting solar heat and we are converting into solar energy. That way we are converting it. Electric motors. Now, when we go for this electric motors, let us understand what is a motor now. What is a motor and what is a dynamo? You are reading in physics. Motor is electrical power to mechanical power. Dynamo is mechanical power to electrical power. Converts it. Dynamo and motor. And here we are talking about motors. Imagining a future where clean air is no longer a dream and our cities are not smog-filled, concrete jungles could well become a reality in the coming years if the world begins to increasingly adopt the use of cleaner options like alternate fuel vehicles. Now, let us just imagine. We should have jungles with plants, but population is increasing. We are planning it, we are controlling it, everything is there, but even then it is increasing. Why? Because the multiplicity is a natural phenomenon. It has to. If a man has two sons, the two sons have two, then it is in the increasing only. It will never stop unless the man stops generating. That we cannot do. It has to be generated. So slowly, slowly, what happens is we have to occupy every inch which is supposed to be left for the plants. Then every fellow wants his own residence, a place to shelter himself. I don't say residence means a pakka building. Then now we have the already apartment culture. 20-storied building. Maybe then the every city may become a concrete jungle. Means the radiation of sunlight will be more and more and more. 5 years ago or 10 years ago, the temperature levels were not this. Now we are finding, oh, it has crossed 47. Oh, next year it may cross to 52. Why this? Oh, it may cross to. Do you mean to say there are two suns burning in the sky? They are emitting that kind of a heat, yeah? Doubled it. In fact, the solar heat is reducing. But we feel the temperature is increasing. Why that? Earlier, radiation is directly falling on the earth, and the earth is emitting the very same, reflecting the very same heat, and that reflection is irregular because the earth is not smooth everywhere. So because of the irregularity, and we were arresting that radiation, that is the reflection of heat, we were regulating it, having thatched roofs, having this tiled roofs. What were we doing is we were restricting the reflection of heat. Radiation was curbed. Now we are having the concrete building very smooth outside. And so the reflection is very irregular. Right? And that very regular reflection, again, you have the tar roads or concrete roads. There also the reflection of heat is more. One from the sun and one from the concrete reflections. Then what will happen? You just think about it. Right? So there, what happens is, for instance, filled concrete jungle could well become a reality in the coming years if the world begins to increasingly adopt the use of cleaner options like alternate fuel vehicles. Not only that, your vehicles are emitting smoke. Emitting smoke means what? It is just like a balloon to have that heat carry with them. Because it cannot mix into the air. Air has also a capacity to take in certain thing. If it can't take it, it will be leaving it. That makes radiation. The pollution may also cause more radiation of heat. Because the air cannot contain that. Right? So we have to think about more other alternative fuels and emitting energy. The rise in economic activity and the burgeoning population have led to a tremendous demand in the transport sector, especially in urban India. By 2020, India's urban population is expected to grow fivefold to a staggering 200 million, while pollution is expected to grow 7 times. You see the statistics. By 2020 means only 3 years more to go. What would happen? The thing what we are going, which as we have studied, tremendous demand for transport sector. Now, for every festive season, the state transport and the railway. Not only these two, this airways also. They are increasing their plying their own means of transport between two places. They are increasing. Even then, by 2020, it should be put to 5 times more. Now just imagine your Panchakutta junction or any square of any city, just imagine. Now it is already a standstill position for us together. And if it is fivefold, then what would occur to you? And even if you are there in that stagnated traffic, you feel itching all over your body because of the pollution levels. If it is fivefold increased, increase of population fivefold, but transportation necessities increase 7 times. That is the statistics by 2020. Unless you go for some other alternative fuel, right? Whatever you feel that it is enough, fuel is there, petrol is there, that may also come to a zero level one day. The rise in economic activity and the burgeoning population have led to a tremendous demand in the transport sector, especially in urban India. By 2020, India's urban population is expected to grow fivefold to a staggering 200 million, while pollution is expected to grow 7 times. With this tremendous growth has emerged a very critical issue of keeping air and noise pollution in urban areas under control. Now, here, one word is burgeoning. Burgeoning is speedily developing plus increasing. If not, the increasing, ever increasing population would have been put. But the population is increasing and also they are developing also. So that is the population have led to a tremendous demand in the transport sector. So earlier, people used to fear to travel from one place to another place. Though there are very less means of transport, people hardly used to use that means of transportation. Yearly ones are once in 5 years or once in 2 years. Even you can see the LTA norms over there. All the government employees, they get LTA, leave travel allowance. What the norm is, it is non-taxable in a span of 4 years twice. But every year they get it. Means what? For 4 years, they have to travel twice. Right? So, this is the norm. It has been surveyed. At that period, people seldom used to travel. If at all they travel, they were traveling once in a 5 year span or once in 2 year span. So let us take the minimum 2 year span. Likewise, it has come into existence. The rule or the norms. So now, if you see there is a holiday for continuously 4 days, people are traveling. People are going back to their places, coming again. Even if it is not for their own places, they may go to Tirupati, they may go to Shirdi Sai. And likewise, they are, what we can say is, traveling has become a routine thing for them. A monthly expenditure or a consumable item it has become. Traveling has become a consumable item. So they go. And so now the transportation from here to Haridwar by buses, by trains, the contractors have come, they are arranging facilities, all these things. Why? People want to travel. More or less, they have become nomadic once again. They are not sticking to their house. How long? For 5 months I was here. Let me move. So that is the tendency. Also the increase in the population, it has demanded the conveyance, system of conveyance, system of transportation. So as the transportation is increased, now it is expected by 2020, the population may grow fivefold, which is very nearly to 200 millions, while the pollution due to the transportation and all these things, it may increase to fivefold, sevenfold. That way it has been calculated and surveyed. And if this is tremendous transportation system and pollution, if it is grows, again pollution grows in twofold again, in multiple. What is it one? Pollution due to smoke and dust and everything. Air pollution. And next is the engine sound, roaring sound of the engine and honking of horns. Here I would like to say a certain thing, honking of horns. What is this? The driver feels driving is nothing but to honk the horn. Whether it is necessary or not, he will be just pushing, pressing the horn. He knows pretty well, this traffic jam is there, unless this green signal falls, I cannot move, and the fellow who is just in front of me cannot move. He knows it. But even the dum, dum, dum. Then it becomes a hell of a, hell we can say, not hell of a, hell of a sound, and it becomes hell also there at that traffic signal. And nobody bothers for other, no consideration at all. Why? First is fear. Second is no confidence. And third is, I probably don't know driving. Panicky. Hysteria, hysteric. People become hysteric there. And so the honking of horns, and it is well known thing, there at the signal I will have to wait for 2 minutes, 120 seconds. Not more than that. He knows it pretty well. Even then he doesn't want to cut the engine down. People, if we may think he is not aware of it. The radios are telling, the televisions are telling, and even every traffic signal we have put the signboards. What is that one? You cut the engine. But nobody wants to. Earlier it was a diesel engine for the trucks. If it is cut, it may not start. So we can understand that kind of vehicles. Even government is trying to ban the vehicles which are aged above 15 years. They want to ban. But no, the owners do not want. They don't want to get them repaired and pass it for again. And they don't want to discard them. And simply, if the 15 years old vehicles are banned, then half of the traffic may be reduced, will be reduced. So let us not, we are not talking about that, but we are talking about the growing concern about your pollution of your environment, because of all these things only. If we can have 3 lakh electric vehicles solution, you see, we are talking about all the problems earlier. Now what are the solution? If we have 3 lakh electrical vehicles, EVs, in short, on the roads by 2020, there is a devil sprint here, a zero has been eliminated, it is not 220, it is 2020, the year 2020, including 3 wheelers, cars and scooters, means 3 lakhs of cars alone, no, all inclusive 3 lakhs vehicles if we have, we would have reduced pollution by 16 lakhs metric tons, saved 3,700 Indian currency, sorry, 3,700 crores of Indian currency in foreign exchange, right? So foreign exchange earnings, and substantially reduce health care costs. What is this health care costs? you sneeze, you cough, you have temperature, then you'll go to doctor. And the doctor will prescribe you for this tests. Because dengue is there, you see, chikungunya is there, see, and bird flu is there, you see. New names for new kinds of your disorders. And no doctor knows under what circumstances you had been to the doctor. No doctor wants to know. Why? The doctors were also made to do such kind of a thing only. Because if a patient comes to me, if I am a doctor, if I prescribe something, right, and if that goes wrong, then the media, the people, the police, the administration, everybody will be after me. Why to take risk? Very simple. Let him go and get him checked for all these things. And all these tests and checks, they will be costing not less than 50,000. The news, today's news, it is. For a simple fever of 72 hours, the so-called your hospitals, sophisticated ones, they are prescribing all kinds of tests on you. And that is coming to 50,000. That is only tests. And about what about the bed, etc.? What are the room charges? What are other services? See the thing. And these all are happening because you are living in a polluted environment. Very simple as that. If that pollution has come down due to the usage of EVs, so the cost, medical cost will also come down. Healthcare cost will also be coming down. Right? So, small electric buses, three-wheelers, and electric scooters are ideal for city mobility. Within the city, if you are to move, maybe a distance of 20, 25 kilometers or 30 kilometers. Because every Hyderabadi has to travel every day not less than 50 kilometers from his home to working place, from his home to his school. He has to. So for this mobility within the city, these ideal vehicles are non-smoking vehicles. Which are these non-smoking vehicles? Electrical scooter, electrical three-wheeler, electrical four-wheelers. If they are put in, so you see, how many advantages do we have for this? Internal combustion machine. What is this? Those which are your scooter is fitted with, your car is fitted with, your three-wheeler is fitted with, and your trucks and all these things are fitted with internal combustion machine. Right? There, the petrol or the gas, whatsoever it goes, it is ignited. Then, due to the heat, it gets, when it is ignited, there is a small burst because of the compressedness within that area. Right? And then, your piston, it moves. When it is moved, the pressure is released and again it goes back. When it is moving to and fro, there is a wheel connected to it with a connecting rod. And that wheel is going round. As speedily it goes, that speedily the wheel goes round. And to that your engine is connected. And so, first of all, you have to ignite it, get it started. For that electricity again required, for that you are using your battery. You see how many things are there. Then your engine gets started and then we are putting accelerated. Then you are changing the gear. Gear pedal is required for it. Clutch, and you are pressing the clutch and changing the gear. When you have changed your gear from 1 to 2, your mobility starts. Then you release your leg from the clutch. Then again, you are to change into 3. Again, pressing clutch and change to 3. Increased, speed increased. And again, you are pressing the clutch, 4. In the same manner, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, again you have to press clutch. Means you are to what we can say, play your legs between accelerator, brake and clutch.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.